Welcome to episode 4. In today's video, I will be rebuilding and restoring the front and rear shocks. I will begin with the rear shock. The first thing I'm going to do is to see if there is any pressure left inside, as these contain nitrogen at 284 pounds per square inch when new. Well, that's a bit anticlimactic. We have zero pressure left, although it's not really surprising when you remember that it is 36 years old. Well, it's safe to say that this oil has seen better days. Couple that with the lack of nitrogen in the shock, and that equals one very bouncy ride. Thank you. So this is what's inside the rear shock. You have your valve stack here, which controls the flow of oil and the damping effect. And this is the seal head. This is what keeps the oil inside the shock. So this is the part we need to replace. There's nothing in the valve stack that I need to replace. So this will be taken off, and so will the seal head. And then we can vapor blast the rest of this. So let's do that. In order to be able to remove the valve stack and seal head, first I need to grind away this locking ring. So with the bladder removed from the reservoir, that's the rear shock fully disassembled. Now I need to wash all the oily parts before we can start vapor blasting. Before I start blasting the alloy parts, I need to put the steel parts in rust heater to prepare them for replating. So while I've been busy working on all the other parts, I sent the rear spring out for blasting and re-powder coating. And this is it before, and this is what it looks like now. With all the parts now fully restored, it's time to reassemble them into a working shock absorber. Thank you. and that's the main body of the shock belt. I'm not going to fit the spring just yet, as I need to build the reservoir first. So let's get on with that. Because this shock has a remote reservoir, I'm pre-filling and bleeding the air from the shock to save time later on trying to fill the shock body through the reservoir and hose. It just saves a lot of hassle doing it this way. Now it's time to remove the air from this link pipe. It's simply a case of compressing the shock, and the oil in the shock will force the air out and out through this adjuster here. Once the air is out, I need to fill this reservoir with oil and then re-extend the shock, and that will pull all the oil back into the shock, and then we can put the adjuster valve back in. So let's do that. With the shock now 99% complete, what I like to do is, instead of fitting the spring, is to get it repressurized with nitrogen. As you can see, no gas means no return. And now, with it pressurized with nitrogen, you can see the shock functions beautifully and has no leaks. So, we can now fit the spring. And now to add a little bit of authenticity to the restoration, a nice yellow check mark. Since no one makes the correct decals for these shocks anymore, I had to design and print my own. All I need to do now is cut them out and apply them, and that will be the rear shock fully restored. And there we have it, all rebuilt and ready for many years more service. You may remember at the beginning of the video, I said I'd be restoring the front shocks too, but due to a few issues, I will be doing them next time. And as usual, a big shout out goes to all my patrons who help keep these restorations going.